The hierarchy window contains a list of every game object in our current scene. Game objects are listed in the hierarchy window in the order that they are added or created. As game objects are added and removed from our scene, they will appear and disappear from the hierarchy as well. The hierarchy lists our game objects in groups known as parents and children. The topmost game object or scene is called the parent or parent object. And all game objects grouped underneath the parent are called children or child objects. We can use the drop-down icon next to the name of a parent game object in the hierarchy to show its children. A parent can have multiple children. Game objects that share the same parent are known as siblings. Note that game objects can also have nested parent-child objects. Nested parent-child objects are known as descendants of the top-level parent. We can reorder our game objects in the hierarchy by dragging them up or down within the hierarchy or by making them child or parent objects. If a game object has no parent, its transform properties are measured in world space. If the game object is then moved in the hierarchy and made a child of another game object, its transform properties will be measured relative to the transform of its parent. If we select a parent game object and move it in the scene view, we can see that its children are also affected by the transform. This also applies to scale and rotation. If we want to change the transform of a single child, we can simply select the child game object in the hierarchy and adjust it accordingly. At the top of the hierarchy window is the toolbar. The toolbar contains a create menu button for adding new game objects into our scene and a search bar to help find items in the hierarchy window. The create menu button allows us to create new empty game objects or pre-made game objects for use in our scene. The create menu button mirrors the first part of the game object menu in the menu bar. In this menu, we can choose to create an empty game object, 3D game objects such as primitives, terrain and trees, 2D sprites, UI objects, and other pre-made game objects. It's worth noting that it's possible to have more than one scene open in the hierarchy window at any one time. For more information on multi-scene editing, see the information linked below. Next to the create menu button is the search bar. The search bar helps us easily identify game objects in our scene and works in a similar way to the search bar in the scene view and the project window. Searching for an item lists any game object in the hierarchy window whose name matches the search criteria. Alternatively, we can search for any game object that contains a component whose type matches the search criteria. It's worth noting that this search filters both the hierarchy window and the scene view, showing only the matching game objects in both windows. If we select a game object from a search, at the bottom of the hierarchy window, the nested path to the selected game object is listed. If we cancel a search, the game object remains selected, and its parents are expanded, helping us to easily identify that game object's location within the list. As we can see, the hierarchy view lists all of the game objects in our scene and allows us to organize and sort them with ease.